Downtown Dreamin'. Is this gonna go like on the like Tijuana radio?
A Kia Telemundo. Enchiladas. Fajitas. Tortillas.
All right, everyone. I'm Kenny Mack, and I'm with some goofball boys from Brady. Who here has a girlfriend? What's your best pickup line?
Hey, you got something in... Oh, my goodness, your eyes.
Oh. What is something really embarrassing?
Last year.
Someone at our hotel room decided to wake up in the middle of the night and make coffee. Chad. And he walks down to the thingy-ma-bobber downstairs. So I got a cup, and I put in the toilet, and then I poured toilet water in his coffee because he made me mad.
Oh, I love it. And you drank that coffee? Come here. Chad, you keep stepping off. Come here, Chad. How did that coffee taste?
It was cold.
Stay over here, Chad. Do you like coffee still?
No.
Y'all remember when Joe used to have regular hair? Now it looks like a freaking porcupine. Looks like a little orange I could just squeeze.
Worst thing your parents made you do when you were a kid?
When I was a little kid, when me and my brother got in trouble, my dad, he would tell us to run. He'd give us 3 seconds to run. He said, don't look back. And you know, if we look back, we're either getting hit in the face with a chunkla flying at us or something.
If you were stranded on an island, what food would you bring?
If you eat a whole can of corn the first day, you can just rewash it and then it's there again.
Oh, no. Oh, my God. I'm Kenny Mack.
And we're the Brady Bulldogs.
And this is Fox News First.
Here we go.
We've just changed a lot over the years, and I guess nobody's really gotten in their own groove with the same coach, and it's kind of hard because we're always switching coaches, and as soon as we get on track, it just falls apart again.
In my career here in Brady, I've learned over 500 plays.
It's kind of hard having every year so far a coach leave us at the end of the season. I don't really know yet, but I'm hoping for this season to be more successful than my past 3 years here.
How awesome would it feel if, you know, your senior year, you go far, further than you've been every other year?
It would be amazing. It would be a blessing to me. East would have said he's planned staying on here, and that's what I hope for the little kids, for the lower classmen, because if he stays, they are going to be successful. They have a lot of talent already.
Today is discipline. Tomorrow's going to be finished.
Coach Easterwood, he's a great coach.
Hustle around.
We've seen what he did with Brownwood team. We've seen what he did with San Saba, turning them from 2-8 to 9-3. We're hoping he comes here and can get us past playoffs to play for Thanksgiving.
We're going to win playoff games. We're going to win playoff games.
He's bringing in a lot of new energy to the team, and he's not just coaching us to be better athletes, but he's coaching us to be better men, and that's really all that we can ask for.
Hey, you got to have mental discipline to be able to battle through this. Today's Discipline Tuesday.
What has he taught you guys so far this summer?
11-30. 11 men of the ball and 3 and out. We got FCFD, FCFD, compete, or finish, compete, discipline, and finish, and family. Let me redo that. Family, discipline, finish, compete. Finish is third. Finish is third. It's F. Have you not seen the Twitter hashtag?
Family, discipline today, finish tomorrow.
Yes, it's finish. Finish is tomorrow. Compete. Family, discipline. Okay, I'm ready.
I'm live in Brady where there is a fight breaking out.
All right, can I redo that? What was the question? Okay, it's 11:30, 11 minute ball, 11 minutes of the ball, 3 and out, and FDFC, finish, discipline, compete, and family.
Mental discipline to battle through this right here, all right? Battle through that adversity, just like the story we talked about yesterday.
You know, I think they have high hopes as far as wanting us to stay around for a while, and you know, this is, you know, I think I've told you this before, but this is my dream job. It's home for me, and it's something that, you know, I just told my wife last night. I said, you know, I don't want to let anyone down, and that's the goal, and including our kids, our coaches that we brought here, our the rest of our Bulldog family, which is our community and the parents, you know, all of that, and so with that added pressure, if you will, I can tell you right now that we're all very passionate about that and about our kids and about turning this deal around. And so we do have some, even though we do have young kids, we have young kids who are, they're going to fight tooth and nail to the very
end. One, two, three,
family!
Come here, Chad. Come here, Chad.